flashpoint, and it's polarized the region. So what's the issue here, besides the obvious brutality?
Absolutely, not such a travesty. We're seeing that a child was raped in the first place to send a message to her nomadic Muslim tribe and to drive them out of that particular village in Jammu and Kashmir. The basis of this case was that the charge sheet was blocked. The agitators demanded the release of the Hindu criminals, alleging that they had been framed. On top of that, and this is the worst part, the government has remained completely silent on the issue. They've not condemned the horrific rape despite the national outcry. And this is really surprising because a lot of people are questioning the fact that it had been a Hindu girl who had been brutally raped and murdered like this inside a mosque. How would the government have reacted then? And the fact that also remains to be questioned is that why are we seeking the religion of this child instead of seeking justice? And I'm speaking to you right now as a Hindu, a secular Hindu, and I can tell you that's not what Hinduism is about. It's a peaceful religion. We worship our goddesses. We respect our women. Therefore, this is diabolical that it's been polarized, it's been politicized, and this entire issue has been communalized.
No, I mean, this is an absolutely awful pet case, but it is just one of 40,000 registered rape cases in India in 2016. And, you know, we're also hearing from rights activists that thousands of rapes go unreported because of stigma. So what explains this prevalence of rape crimes, and what can the government do to stop this?
You know, again, this is such a travesty in our country. The 40,000 women who are raped every year, that means every 13 a woman is raped. That's 110 women every single day. India is the rape capital of the world, third after the US and Africa. And despite that, the punishment that's meted out to these perpetrators is almost nil. There have been only two cases where we've seen that capital punishment has been doled out, and that's been in the rarest of rare cases. The problem is that our legal system is laborious, it's archaic, it's extremely intimidating for any woman. The police stations are not equipped to handle such cases. If you remember, there was Jyoti Singh who, in December 2012, the famous Nirbhaya case, there was a fund that was allocated after the national outcry of 3,000 crore, that's 30 billion rupees. That fund was to help women under duress, to restore the safety and dignity. That's what the government had promised the women of India, but nothing has happened so far. These one-stop centers that were supposed to provide free legal, medical, psychiatric aid to women under duress, it's not coming to effect. There are no women personnel in police stations who are aiding women who walk into the police station, and they can wait. There's no medical evidence. There's only one judge for every 100,000 people. The conviction rates in India for every crime is low, but particularly for rape, it's abysmally low at 27%. So even if you look at Saudi Arabia, they behead men who rape. Even in China, they castrate them. But in India, the men get away scot-free. So there's no impunity granted to them. Why would they stop raping?
An awful situation. Well, thank you very much, Meghna Pant in Mumbai.